Do you know what your blood pressure is or why it's important? Well, in today's video, I'm going to teach you four key things all about it, like why knowing your blood pressure is important, how you can test your blood pressure at home, what the results actually mean, and what you can do to improve your blood pressure. Guys, this information could save your lives. G'day there, I'm Jesse Crowe, the traveling scientist. And after spending years studying pharmacology, I'm here to help you live smarter, happier, healthier lives. So why do you need to know your blood pressure? Well, your blood pressure is an indication of your risk of suffering from a heart attack or a stroke. And the higher that your blood pressure is, the higher your risk of just dropping dead. High blood pressure, also known as hypertension, can be caused by a number of different things. A stressful life, an unhealthy diet, even a lack of exercise. But you won't know if you have high blood pressure unless you get it tested. Now you might say, Jesse, I'm young, I exercise, I eat right, my blood pressure's fine. But is it really? Are you sure? Anybody can have high blood pressure, and people in their 20s and 30s can die from a sudden heart attack or stroke. My own grandmother, who seemed perfectly healthy, passed away from a sudden and fatal heart attack in her 40s. I never even got to meet her. This happened before I was born. So the point is that this can happen to anybody, and that's why it's really important to know your blood pressure. And back in the day, the only way to check your blood pressure was to go and visit the doctor. But now, you can test your blood pressure at any time in the comfort of your own home. Presenting the Sinocare Blood Pressure Monitor. This is exactly like what a doctor would use to check your blood pressure in the office. But you can use this at home anytime you want. And I'm going to show you how it works right here, right now. Just let me slip into something a little more comfortable. I should probably start an OnlyFans for this type of content. Anyway, you just slip it on your arm here, tighten it up a little bit, and press the start button.
Your blood pressure is systolic. 124 millimeter of mercury. Diastolic, 83 millimeter of mercury. Your pulse was 65.
So there you go. That's my blood pressure there. Give me right away, 124 over 83. That's slightly above average, but we'll talk about that more in just a moment. Now, I would recommend doing this every day, maybe even twice a day, because your blood pressure will vary over time, and it's important to know your average blood pressure, rather than just getting one reading and being like, holy crap, that's high, I'm gonna die. But seriously guys, I'm not trying to be a salesman here, but this machine is really cool, and it's actually a lot cheaper than you'd expect. So if you're thinking about getting one, there's a link in the description just down below. And you can even get a discount if you use my coupon code, which is also in the description down below. And I earn a little bit of money, and you know, this machine could save your life. So definitely consider it. Because Sinocare cares about you. So now you know your blood pressure, what now? Well, your blood pressure is made up of two numbers. The first number is systolic, which is how much pressure your blood is exerting against the artery walls when your heart's beating. The second number is diastolic. And this is how much pressure your blood is exerting against the artery walls when your heart is at rest. And a standard healthy blood pressure is 120 systolic over 80 diastolic. Remember, the higher your blood pressure, the higher your risk of suffering from a cardiac event like a stroke or a heart attack. So if your blood pressure is something like 110 systolic over 70 diastolic, then that's very healthy and you're at low risk. However, if your blood pressure is closer to 140 systolic over 90 diastolic, then that's really high and you have serious hypertension. You should see your doctor immediately and try to find ways of lowering your blood pressure to reduce your risk of ending up in hospital. And I just want to give you a few quick tips on what you can do to reduce your blood pressure. Regular exercise, which trains your heart to work more efficiently to reduce the pressure on your artery walls.
Jogging. I believe it's jogging or yogging. It might be a soft J.
Stress less, because being stressed raises your blood pressure. So removing stresses from your life could save your life.
Get that off of me!
Reduce sodium intake, because salt increases your blood pressure and makes your heart work harder. So be nice to your heart and take a little bit less salt. Finally, smoking and drinking. These are both really common and really unhealthy habits that promote hypertension. So less ciggies and less alcohol means less blood pressure. Woohoo!
It's the feeling good all the time, huh?
So now you know all about blood pressure and you can test yours in the comfort of your own home. Remember, there's a link in the description just down below if you want your own Sinocare blood pressure monitor. It's a really handy machine to have. And if you discover that your blood pressure is a little bit high, there are steps that you can take to reduce it so that you can start living a smarter, happier, and healthier life. Anyway, that's all for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video or learned something, click the like button down below. And let me know what your blood pressure is in the comment section down below, and I'll give you some unsolicited advice. Finally, next week's video is going to be all about getting your blood tested to see how healthy you really are. So make sure you subscribe for Traveling Science every single week. I'll see you guys next Science Sunday. Cheers. Your blood is exerting against the artillery walls. Artillery. Apparently there's like giant cannons in your bloodstream. Is it really? Jesse, I'm young, I'm healthy, I eat right, my blood pressure's fine. And I would say something like, what is that accent? Where the hell did that come from? Where are you from, random person that I just made up?